the 14th of December 2022 digitalworldvision.online. Marketing targeting. This video learn in layman's terms why some business blow thousands of dollars in marketing and others make thousands. Expert marketer Mike Martin from the United Kingdom explains this video is worth you few minutes time if the light bulb goes on for you.
Good, which is awesome. Well, today I'm back on father duties. So today I want to talk to you about the thing I believe is the number one reason most businesses fail, right? And when I say most businesses, I mean most businesses fail. And I think there's a... I think it starts from when we're in school. Obviously, my son will turn up and he'll ask me, Dad, I want to be X, Y, Z when I leave school. And I'll turn around and say to him, okay, well, you need to obviously work hard, you need to study, you need to do all the things that you need to do, but you also need to learn to market your business, right? Because let's say you want to be a personal trainer. How many personal trainers work at gyms on minimum wage, okay? They work really hard, they stay super fit, they look after the diet, they do all the crazy shit that none of us real normal humans can stick by. I mean, I can't stop eating, right? And then they make almost no money at all. But if they learn to be a personal trainer and they learn to be a marketer, they can make millions. And that's why you get these multi-millionaire marketers who are just personal trainers, but they make absolute millions because normal humans like us, or like most people, can't keep a six pack and we can't stop eating chocolate after 8 o'clock at night and stuff like that. So it doesn't work. So I think it starts there. I think one of the big reasons people fail, or the big reason businesses fail, is you're taught that if you go to school, you want to be an architect, train, go through school, go through college, go through uni, and then you got to go and find a fucking job as an architect. And what if you can't find a job? You work at McDonald's. So it doesn't make any sense. But if you're an architect, you are the business. If you're a dentist, you are the business. If you're a personal trainer, you are the business. If you understand how to market, right? So that's the start, okay? But I think the biggest reason that businesses fail, in fact, let me tell you a story. So when we lived in Spain, we found these tablets, right? We found these tablets that you could put in your swimming pool, right? They were like about this big, but like a half a bar of soap. Throw it in your swimming pool and your swimming pool would change colour, so you'd go out and your swimming pool would be pink, right? 24 hours later, your pool had gone back to normal, all right? So you throw it in the pool, it'd turn your swimming pool pink, it'd look pink for a day, and then it'd go back to being bluey, greeny colour, whatever the normal colour was. And there were different colours you could get and you could throw them into your swimming pool. So the kids were like, all right, let's go and turn the sea pink. So it was like, okay, let's go down to the beach. So we went down, chuck one of these tablets in the sea, it did buck all, which is kind of obvious. It's the sea, it's massive, it's not gonna think it. So what most marketers do, or not most marketers, most business owners, most people trying to market the business, and most marketers actually, is they don't follow a principle called inch wide, mile deep, okay? They don't target their specific niche market. So if you target your specific niche market and you set up an advertising or marketing or promotion for that particular industry, what it'll do is it'll cover the whole niche, the way the swimming pool could change color, and then 24, 48 hours later, every part of the niche has been touched by that marketing promotion, and you've spent enough money to make it profitable. Whereas with what most people do is like, well, everybody's my target market. I want to market my business to absolutely everybody. And it does nothing, because it's like throwing that tablet in the ocean that basically did nothing, it just disappeared. And unless you've got sort of Coca-Cola money or Rolls Royce money or Mercedes money or anything like that to market on a huge scale and become a brand, you have to target a specific market. Now, it's the same with personal trainers. Let's say you're a personal trainer and you want to target marketing yourself as a personal trainer to specific people. If you try and target just anyone anywhere in the world, you're never going to make it. But let's say you target retired people who want to be able to just keep fit in the later years and want a daily routine that they can go through that's not too rigorous, that's not like fucking 300 press ups a day and all the rest of that stuff. You target them, you set a specific thing, you market to those people, you market to those demographics with your advertising campaign. It's still a massive market, so you could target women between 65 and 75, or you could market to people who are off school during the summer holidays and want to keep fit, because when they get back to school they want to be a specific ready for football practice and all that. You find where they go, how to market to them, use the demographics online to market to them. You target that specific niche, and because you know exactly who your customer is, you know exactly how to market, you know exactly what to say, you know exactly who you're talking to. So what I'm saying is, if when you're trying to market your business, when you're trying to go out, in ours, it's a lot to do with lead generation. We're targeting plumbers, roofers, electricians, joiners, but you can't take the full fucking industry, okay? You can't take them all. So take a section, inch wide, mile deep, okay? So it's a small section of the industry, but there's a ton of work in it. Like boiler inspections is a perfect example, or underfloor heating is a perfect example. Go after a niche that you can make a big fucking dent in and you can take a percentage of, rather than just trying to target absolutely every business. And no matter how much money you throw at it, you're always going to be sat there saying, we just didn't have enough money, or it just didn't work, or the marketing wasn't right. It's not, it's your targeting that needs to be right. So if you push towards marketing to the right people with the right message, your business will work. And I think that's the biggest reason most businesses fail, okay, is because even those that understand marketing and actually want to do some marketing, they don't get it right because they don't realize that you have to specifically target a market to a niche that you can afford to dominate.